rising early in the morning, we proceed to light the fire. Then our majesty, adorning in its workaday attire, we embark without delay on the duties of the day. First we polish off some batches of political dispatches or foreign politicians circumvent. Then if business isn't heavy, we may hold a royal levy or ratify some acts of parliament. Then we probably review the household troops with the usual shallow humps and shallow hoops, or receive with ceremonial and state an interesting Eastern potentate. After that, we generally go and dress our private valet. It's a rather nervous duty, he's a touchy little man. Write some letters literary for our private secretary. He is shaky in his spelling, so we help him if we can. Then in view of craving's inner, we go down and order dinner. Then we polish the regalia and the coronation plate. Spend an hour in titivating all our gentlemen in waiting, or we run on little errands for the ministers of state. Oh, philosophers may sing of the troubles of a king, yet the duties are delightful and the privilege is great. But the privilege and pleasure that we treasure beyond measure is to run on little errands for the ministers of state.
Oh, philosophers may sing of the troubles of a king, yet the duties are delightful and the privilege is great. But the privilege and pleasure that we treasure beyond measure is to run on little errands for the ministers of state.
After luncheon, making merry on a bun and glass of sherry, if we've nothing in particular to do, we may make a proclamation or receive a deputation, then we possibly create a peer or two. Then we help a fellow creature on his path with the garter or the thistle or the bath. Then we dress and toddle off in semi-state to a festival, a function, or a fete. Then we go and stand a sentry at the palace private entry, marching hither, marching thither, up and down and to and fro, while the warrior on duty goes in search of beer and beauty, and it generally happens that he hasn't far to go. He relieves us if he's able, just in time to lay the table. Then we dine and serve the coffee, and at 12:30 or 1, with a pleasure that's emphatic, we retire to our attic with the gratifying feeling that our duty has been done. Oh, philosophers may sing of the troubles of a king, but of pleasures there are many, and of worries there are none. And the culminating pleasure that we treasure beyond measure is the gratifying feeling that our duty has been done.
Oh, philosophers may sing of the troubles of a king, but of pleasures there are many, and of worries there are none. And the culminating pleasure that we treasure beyond measure is the gratifying feeling that our